Hi, I'm Preeti. Welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are doing well. And today's video is probably the most requested video that I've got on my channel, and it's about hair fall. I've had the worst experience with hair. As you can see from my pictures, there was a time where I had almost lost all of my hair, and my friends and family don't consider it anything less than a miracle that I've actually managed to get all of my hair back, and this time much more healthier than they were before. But nothing in life is a miracle, and you have to work towards it. So here are my 10 tips and tricks on how to bring your hair back to life. My first tip is iron deficiency. Not a lot of people are aware that excessive hair fall and hair fall in bunches can be an indication of an underlying medical condition, most commonly iron deficiency. So the first thing you need to do is walk into your nearest clinic and get your hemoglobin levels checked. On deficiency, take the suitable supplements prescribed. The second point is in line with the first point, which is nutrition. Now, as I've already mentioned in my first video on how to lose weight, I lost all of my hair due to crash diets and starving myself in order to lose weight. But our hair needs all of the vitamins and minerals in order to stay healthy, and of course 2 to 3 liters of water every day. You know, now I have so much experience with hair that I can actually look at somebody's hair and actually tell that this person does not eat a healthy diet, because our hair, skin and nails are all indicators of how healthy we are. My third tip is hair oil massage. This is the most effective remedy in order to reduce hair fall and stimulate new hair growth, because hair oil massage not only increases blood circulation but also reduces stress, which is another major cause of hair fall. I get a hair oil massage done twice weekly, and I can see a huge difference in my hair with each wash. There are a few things that you need to be careful about and a few things that you need to consider. My next video is completely dedicated only on this topic, so don't forget to subscribe in order to get the notification. And the fourth tip is using wrong products, such as shampoos and conditioner. Always buy a shampoo and conditioner which are sulfate-free and paraben-free. These are chemicals and detergents which your hair does not need. I will list some of these shampoos and conditioners in the description box below. There is one myth surrounding shampoos, that is to use the same shampoo all your life, which is not true. Always buy a shampoo that addresses your hair type or your hair issue, such as oily, dry, dandruff, hair fall, etc. And yes, conditioner is very important in order to avoid dry and brittle hair. Just make sure to apply the conditioner from the midsection to the ends of your hair. And no, conditioner does not cause hair fall. What a moisturizer is to your face, that is exactly what conditioner is to your hair. And the fifth point is apple cider vinegar. After you're done washing your hair, make sure the last rinse is with apple cider vinegar diluted in water. This helps in restoring the pH balance of the hair, gives incredible shine, and also helps keep dandruff at bay. The next tip is chemical treatments such as coloring, smoothening, rebonding. There is always one golden rule which you must follow. Never do 2 chemical treatments at once. If you have colored your hair, don't straighten it. And if you have straightened your hair, don't color it. Because doing 2 chemical treatments at once strains your hair further and completely damages your hair. My 7th tip is hairstyles. Now, this is especially for people with damaged hair. If you already have damaged hair, stop using all styling equipments immediately, such as straightener, curler, hair dryer, no matter how tempting. I know this because I've been through college myself and I had horrible hair, so I would straighten it every day in order to look presentable, but that was the worst thing that I could do because my hair only got worse from there. So in such situations, what you can do is rely on hairstyles such as bun and plaits and ponytails in order to refrain from using any styling equipments. I know that you guys might be worried about the volume in a bun or a plait, but there are a few ways that you can spruce up your volume, and I will show them to you later. The 8th point is stress. dermatologist and every health book ever has always considered stress to be the main cause of hair fall. There are a few ways by which you can relieve your stress, such as meditation, getting enough exercise, having a hobby which you love and which is completely yours. And the next thing is getting enough sleep. With the increase in our data packs and the entertainment that our phone provides, sleep becomes our last priority. And not getting enough sleep wreaks havoc on your hair. And who knows, this might just be the reason for your hair fall. The ninth point is brushing your hair. Yes, brushing your hair can also be an effective remedy of hair fall, because hair fall is not just a hair that falls from your scalp, but it's also the breakage of hair caused due to knots. Have you ever noticed your hair on a windy day or when you've had a bike ride with your hair open, the amount of knots that are developed in the hair, and when you try brush them out, there is a lot of breakage. So always carry a rubber band clip and a comb in your backpack at all times. Brushing your hair also helps distribute the natural oil secreted by your scalp to the rest of the hair. Hence, put a comb in your hair, people. And the last tip of the day is hair packs. Moisturizing and taking care of your hair only makes your hair stronger and helps in reducing breakages. Every weekend, make it a point to apply some form of hair pack to your hair. Either you can buy the hair pack as it is, or you can make your own hair pack at home using aloe vera, eggs, and coconut milk. I do have a few recipes with me, but I will share those with you in the coming weeks. Sometimes it's the smallest things which make all the difference. So here's hoping that my tips and tricks help you and you have beautiful hair in no time. With that, I'd like to say goodbye, but don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment below. See you next week. Bye.